left out in the rain. Razzmatazz springs into life. And talking about being out in the rain, Lynn's feeling a bit left out today. She's not on the show. She's not feeling too well. So get better soon, kid. But I'm here. What? Do that again.
I will.
We've got a great show for you today. We've got the Boomtown Rats, Brendan's along with Popscotch, and we've also got a little jingly jangly thing from the Human League. And Brendan's getting right in the mood, I can see here, for our first guests on the show today, ABC, with Poison Arrow. You can be a real pain in the neck sometimes, son. Here's ABC, here they are! Summer's back for the Boomtown Rats. And our next guest, Bob Geldof. Here he is. Right. Bob, where were you yesterday?
In Bangladesh, and our aunt's trying to fly home. It took about 36 hours.
You've just been touring in the Far East. In fact, we can reveal all. You've got some shoes there, which are absolutely fantastic. Were they a bargain?
These were the bargain of the year. The airfare cost about 350 quid, but the shoes were 30p.
They're fantastic. They're made of plastic.
Yes, so you can have a bath in them. This is one of the main advantages.
What were audiences like out there for the Rats?
Very, more or less the same as here, in particular Bangkok and places like that where they're used to radio and rock and roll and that sort of thing, yeah.
We haven't heard a lot of you, you know, for the last year and a half. You've been uneasily quiet. Why is that?
Well, about last year we toured England and we had Banana Republic and all that stuff, and then we went away again to the East and America and Europe. Then we made this film, at least I made a film called The Wall. And then we did an LP, and that's coming out in 2 weeks, and we're going to Greece, Yugoslavia, Italy, Spain, Portugal, Malta.
You haven't been sitting on your butt, you know what you're saying.
And I mean, I can't help you don't hear from us. I don't write to you. My father hears from me.
Well, in The Wall, the film that you've just mentioned, Jen here was in The Wall. Yeah. What did you have to do for 2 days?
Well, we had to walk along a massive conveyor belt and fall into a sausage machine. Mm. And we had to sing We Don't Need No Education with Zombie Master Song. And we had to smash up the set.
This sounds like a very peculiar film. What's it about, in a nutshell?
In a nutshell, it's the story of a very neurotic man who, because of things that have happened to him throughout his life, eventually cracks up and his worst fears become, to him, very real.
Nathan, you've got a question about The Wall.
Yeah, you had to have your hair shaved off for your part. How did you feel about that?
I didn't have to have my hair shaved off. They wanted me to at first, and then we decided it wasn't a great idea anyway, because it wasn't vanity. I don't mind having it shaved off. It was the permanence of the thing, you know? Like, I mean, it'd take about a year to grow back. So I did shave my eyebrows off, and I shaved the hair on my chest off.
And it was as far as you prepared to go?
I would have gone the whole hog, but it wasn't necessary. But it was a bit weird walking around with no eyebrows for 2 months.
We've got one last question.
Yeah, if you weren't an actor or a singer, what do you think you would be?
Anything really, it wouldn't bother me that much so long as it was fun, so long as I could get around the place.
Anything you've ever particularly fancied when you were at school?
The only one other job, and I've done several, the only one other job that I enjoyed particularly was writing. Mm-hmm. And
you're a journalist, right?
Yeah, so I probably would have been doing that if it hadn't been for this thing.
Well, good luck with your paper round. Bob Geldof from the Boomtown Rats, thank you very much. Give him a cheer, hey! Well, from Bob in Bangladesh to Shocks in Sheffield. Now, what on earth is going on in Sheffield? Back in the 1960s, groups in Liverpool, like the Beatles, led the Merseysound, a style of music which really rocked the world. Now in Sheffield, bands like ABC and Heaven 17 spearhead the new Sheffield sound, sharp as stainless steel. And one such band has really been ravaging the British charts recently. They're Human League. And here's a video of theirs you may not have seen called Open Your Hearts.
Yeah! Surprise!
Hang Up, which is about as much fun as wandering down the street on a winter's night, putting your hand in your trouser pocket and finding another hand already in there. That's a heck of a thing. And here's the Popscotch board, packed with popular portraits of pop stars for our hapless, luckless, no-count contestants to leap to when they hear their hits pounded out on the old pianola by our pianola pounder, the amazing one of three twins, Brendan. Give him a cheer! Special contest for you today. As you can see, the popular Popscotch podium's literally packed with toadstools. Well, there's not much room up here. Oh, well, let me introduce you. We've got two teams of two people. We've arc-welded their legs together. As you can see, we've got the London team here. What's your name?
Jason.
Jason and?
Julia.
Jason and Julia from London. Give them a nice big cheer. And from Manchester, who we got? Manchester, what's your name?
Roy and Linda.
Roy and Linda. I thought the mouse had healed up for a moment there. Give a nice big cheer for the Manchester team. Now, as you know, somewhere hidden on our Popscotch board is a mystery square. And only for those of you at home, here is that mystery square. When our contestants leap on that square, if they can answer a simple, straightforward question, they could win themselves an amazing prize. The way we in the studio will know which square that is Brendan will grab hold of his handle and let rip with this impression of the Stranglers. There's a heck of a thing. Right, without further ado, let's get going with Popscotch, the first tag team contest ever. Tune number one. Off you go. Manchester are there.
Buxfizz.
London Make Believe. Buxfizz, London Make Believe. Tune number two.
Right.
Tune number two. What's it? London are down. That was a bit of a foul. Was that a foul?
No.
Nobody knows.
Tweets
and the birdie song. Another 3 points for Manchester. 6 points. London getting slaughtered here. Let's move on to tune number three. Don't forget to go by the blue squares. London did go by the blue squares. Who was that? Turn around, tell me. What was it? Who is it? Give your mouth
altered
healed
images.
Up. Altered images. And I could be happy. 3 points for London. Manchester 6, London 3, as we move on to tune number 4. Tune number 4. Tune number 4, it's Toya, and it's this week's Mystery Square. Goodness gracious me, give them a cheer. Now then, if you can answer a simple, straightforward question, you can win for yourself this amazing MacGuffin. It may look like an ordinary bottle of pop, but in fact, it is a transistor radio. Here is the question. Now, listen very, very carefully. Listen, watch my lips. Toya's first hit was It's a Mystery. What was the second? What was it, quickly? First hit was...
I want to be free!
That was the secret! And it's now 6-6 as we move on to tune number 5. 6-6, it's neck and neck. 6-6, Brendan playing them like you've never heard them before. They think it's Shaking Stevens, but I don't think they're right. There they are. Manchester got there, a lot of kicking and larking. What was that?
Soft sell.
And the wave, like seasick?
Say hello, wave, goodbye.
Manchester back in the lead by 6, tune number 6. Tune number 6. Was it Human League? Don't you want me, baby? It's now neck and neck once again. It's now 9-0 as we move on to tune number 7. Tune number 7. More fun than you've ever had. There they are. You were there.
Hand held in back.
And that means it's Manchester the winners. Quick as you can, some fabulous prizes. We've got some beautiful briefcases full of singles, cassettes, and LPs. Ooh! And that's a great big cheer for doing so well, Manchester and London, right? What a great game! I believe it!
star Tarzan outside playing on the jungle blues. I know, cause I saw him shimmer in a Kenyan pool. Coming on in the vines with his leopard skin loincloth cool. Only one juicy fingers beating on the bark of a tree. Now Tarzan and me, well, obviously we're like that. Yes, me and Tarzan, where we get on like a house on fire. But look at Kungawee, she's the one with the knick-knack eyes. She's only 17 and she knows how to make boys fight. And she slits you with her eyes and she slashes you with a cutback smile. But she's as cruel as a pig, but we love her like a house on fire. Well, Louise and me now obviously we're like that. Me and Louise, when we get on like a house on fire. Like a house on fire.
Boomtown Rats, one of my favourite bands. Good, aren't they, Nathan?
Yeah, they're really good.
I tell you what it is, I've enjoyed today so much getting Alistair before with a bow and arrow. That was one of the highlights of my life.
Yeah, but you better watch out, because he'll try and get his own back.
Ah, but he couldn't, you see, because, you see, I'm so important, you see, in Razzmatazz that I'm actually in charge of everything. Alistair isn't. You see, Alistair thinks he is, and he thinks he can tell me what to do. But he can't, you see, because I'm the most important. He doesn't even know what's going on half the time. I do. Oh, yeah. And you should Oh, I'm glad it was only water. That's what you think, Bonnie lad. Till next week, bye-bye!
Resurrect.